And let's work on these together, okay? So, you seemed all right here. Good there, no questions were asked. Now we have new equation. There's not any one correct way to even start solving this equation. So let's do something. What can we do?
Plus four.
We add four. Let's see. Could I think the thing that's misleading sometimes is we write this stuff underneath. Can I squeeze a plus four in there? Is there any problem with that?
Yeah.
What's wrong with that? Okay, so if I squeeze a plus four in there and I put plus four on this side, is that okay?
Yeah, if you cross out the plus four and the minus four.
Well, I don't have to. I can just let it sit there forever.
No.
The question is it okay to add four right there? Like, I'm not violating any order of operations, right? Like, just like two sides of a scale, I can drop four on this side and four on this side, right? And what will happen if I drop four on both sides? Was that?
Even.
It'll still be even, right? And that's great. We want these things to stay balanced on both sides. So, if I add 4 to this side, can I add the 4 directly to this negative 4? The answer is yes. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay? I want to add 4 to this side. So if I throw a plus 4 there at the end, would it make any difference if I put that plus 4 here? No, because we have 7x plus negative 4x plus 3x plus 4. We're just adding a bunch of things together, and it won't matter what order I add them in. It's called the commutative property of addition. So instead of adding 4 there, I could add 4 there. We'll add 4 to both sides. And negative 4 plus 4 is?
Negative 4 plus 4 is 0.
Yeah. Right, so Shelby feels better now.
Yes.
We crossed it out. 43 plus 4, 47. And that way.
Divide by 10. Oh, sorry.
Let's add them together first, okay?
I just did two steps.
Because 7x plus 3 more x's is 10x, and then we can divide by 10. X equals 47 over 10, or 4.7 if you like. Could have gone this route. Could just take the 7x and add the 3x to it as my first step. All I did is combine them together, and then I could add 4. And x equals still 47. Divide by 10. Divide by 10. X equals 47 over 10. Same exact answer. Before we do this one, let me give you another one of those just to try out, just to make sure we're all okay with it. Okay, someone start us off.
Negative 14.
Subtract 14, subtract 14. Both sides. Don't make these thing off kilter, unbalanced. 19 minus 14.
5.
That's 5. Okay?
Negative 5.
Negative 8x plus 3x is negative 5x.
Negative
1x. Negative 1x. X equals negative 1x.
Tell me how to find that.
Divide by negative 5.
Okay, divide by negative 5. X equals 5, divided by negative 5 is negative 1.
Yeah.
Whoa. We looked at half on it.
Okay. Already worked on this one.
See.
So together. Let's do something first. Jenna.
So you add the x and the 4 equals 4x.
X plus 4 is 4x?
Yes.
Tell me what this means, 4x. 4 times x. But this says x plus 4. Easier, but is it correct?
No.
In one, get, and here we have x plus 4. This is 4 times x. X plus 4 and 4 times x, just two different things. Distribute the negative 3.
I'm glad it is.
Negative 3 times x?
Negative
3x. Negative 3 times 4?
Negative 12.
Negative 12.
Yeah.
Okay. Carson?
Yeah.
You have something for us to do at this point?
Copy, Carson. Put it on the board, right? You could do 12 plus 12.
Negative 12 plus 12 is 0, which is great. So we have 2x minus 3x equals 19.
Nope. Negative 1x.
2x minus 3x is negative x.
Yeah. Wait.
Negative x equals 19. But we want to know what x is.
Negative 19.
Divide by negative 1 on both sides, and we get x equals negative 19.
Alright.
Or multiply by negative 1 on both sides, negative times negative is positive, and positive times, whether we're dividing or multiplying, we get the same thing. Positive 19 divided by negative 1 is negative 19. Try another one like that. So, where can we start?
Yeah.
All right. See a parentheses with a number multiplied by, we like to distribute. That's a good place to start. Okay?
Oh, it's a little
add 28 to both sides. That'll work. Negative 4x plus 14x plus 3 equals 53. Jenna?
And then you collect like terms with the x's.
Okay, negative 4x plus 14x is?
What color?
10x.
Orange. 10x plus 3.
And you add
53.
5
subtract 3.
Thank you.
Subtract 3, I
hear.
10x equals 50.
And
you
divide by
10. Divide by 10, and x equals 5. We get negative 25, and then at some point probably add 25 to both sides.
Yeah.
25 plus 25 is 50.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That's
that would work too.
Yeah,
good. I'm going to have you try another one because I want to make sure we're all doing all right with it.
I got it right.
Let's begin.
22?
Randy wants to tell us the first thing that we do before he leaves.
Distribute the 5 to the negative 3x, which is 15, or negative 15x. Then it's plus 35 plus 10x. And then plus 4 equals 14 in the front, plus 2x. And then the front is 5.
Okay. Distribute, first step.
That'll be negative 10x. X is basically that.
Negative 10x plus 10x.
X.
Plus 10x.
Equals 1x.
No x's.
Yes.
That's why I messed up that.
Quiet. Pay attention, please. Or at least don't distract other people. Negative 10x plus 10x is 0x. And
No x.
35 plus 4 equals 14 plus 2x.
39
then. Minus 14.
It's
going to
be
25.
Then divided by
2. Yeah, equals 2x divided by
2. Yeah. And you
need to go
12.5 or 12.5.
Or
25
over 2.
What?
I told you wrong, Samantha. I don't know how I told you wrong, Ashton.
Because you're always wrong.
That's a great way to say it to a teacher.
That's so mean.
You tricked me.
I don't know where you got right there.
All right, let's try one where the x's don't cancel each other out.
What? The x is so due, though.
Let's try one where
they don't. Give me my tail. Okay.
All right. First, we can do what? Jenna?
Add 5 to the other side.
Add 5?
Negative.
Subtract 5.
Yeah, there you go.
4x.
7x.
Shh. Only Jenna should be talking. Equals
7x. And that is 3x plus 3x. I mean, not 3x, just plus 3.
Just plus 3.
Sorry, I don't know where I'm at. Why did 3 come back? Then you minus 3 by both sides.
Minus 3 on both sides?
Yes.
Okay. Negative 3 plus 4x equals 7x.
Wait,
we would have, if we had subtracted 8 from the beginning, we would have been right there. But it's not wrong. We're just kind of moving stuff around right now.
Wait, I thought you literally minus 3 by 4. That would be 1x. No.
4x minus 3. We can't put these together. They're not like terms. Okay. The noise tells me that you're all fine. We should just move on to like quadratics.
Three plus
11.
How
much
y'all
just
shut
up? Okay. I'm fine with it. Let's finish this equation before we start doing quadratic functions.
Minus 4x.
Minus 4x.
And then divide by 3, and you're going to get a negative 1 equals x.
Good. Okay. Before we do quadratic functions, let's work on linear functions. Does the word function ring a bell?
Yes.
Okay, that's an example of a kind of a function. But in general, can you tell me what a function is generally?
A rule.
A rule? What does this rule do?
It is the guidelines of a certain certain things, like they substitute stuff that has steps that have to be taken.
so there's some steps. Can you give me an example of a rule?
Yeah, y greater than x plus b.
Okay, how's this a function?
Because you have to follow that. Well, that's not a function, it's a guidelines for a function. But like,
can you give me a specific function?
Okay, y equals 1/3 x plus 2.
Okay, and so what's function-y about this?
I know that I have to start on a quadratic plane or grid. Graph from, because I know that in front of x, m is always going to be slope, and plus or minus the last part, b, is always going to be the y-intercept.
Okay, let's work our way up to that. Okay, let's talk about why this is a function. And why it's a function is a pretty basic thing, okay? It's about input. And what would you guess goes along
output.
With input? Output. Okay. Where does the input go in this function?
The line.
And
no.
The
no.
No. Yeah.
No.
Whatever 3 you need. X.
Input goes right in
y
there for x,
output.
And y is the output. So when we figure out what y is, that's what our output is. So if you can put something in there and get something out, there's a very, very good chance that it's a function. There are some things that you plug things in and get things out, they turn out not to be functions. Okay? But there's such special examples that we won't worry about that at all today. This is a great example of a function. You plug something in for x, you do some arithmetic, and you find the output. Okay? Let me give you a simpler example of a function, and you make it function. Here is a function y equals 2x plus 5. Okay, here's how I want you to make it function.
Oh.
We have an xy table or a function table or some kind of a table, whatever you call it. Let's give it some inputs and see what kind of outputs we get. Okay? So, in case you're not clear on what that means, x is going to, like, we're going to plug something in for x 5 different times. First time we'll do negative 2, then negative 1, then 0, then 1, then 2. Okay. And every time we plug that in, we'll find out what the output is. We'll plug in something for x, do the math. Lo and behold, that's what y is, because y is equal to whatever this side is. Once you plug in x, you know what y is. Okay. So finish this table for all 5 of those. On your okay. So for the first one, x is negative 2. So you have negative 4 plus 5 is 1. Negative 1. That's negative 2 plus 5.
3.
0. 0 plus 5.
7.
2 times positive 1 plus 5. That's 2 plus 5. That's 7. 2 times 2 plus 5 equals 4 plus 5. Now, notice, or here, let's say, if I just kept going, say I went all the way to 13 without plugging 13 into the function. Can you notice a pattern in the outputs? From here to there, there to there. Then we could follow and figure out
two.
The output here.
You add 2 every time.
Add 2 every time, add 2, and so on and so on and so on. So to get from 2 to 13, how many 2's would I have to add on?
11
2's, right? I would add 2 to get to the next one if I plugged 3, right? Then I would just add 2, then add 2 to what I would get if I plugged in 4,
so
add 2 again and again and again and again. So we'd have to add 2 times 11, right? 11 2's.
22.
22.
31? No, 33. Today is Wednesday.
22.
Tomorrow is Western
no, 30.
Day.
35.
Plus
9. 35.
No. Okay, now I'm lost.
Okay. We started 9
is 31.
And I add 22.
9 plus 22? Okay, that would be 31.
That is 31.
Problem is
okay.
Shelby, you confused me.
I did, I confused myself.
Let's see if that's true. 2 times 13 plus 5, that's 26 plus 5, that's 31. So this pattern that we notice, it has a special name.
Slope.
It is a slope.
Woo.
If we were to look at the graph, this pattern we would refer to on the graph as a slope.
1 over 2.
2 over 1?
2 over 1,
So let's plot some points. What are some points that belong to this function's graph?
-2 and 1.
Negative 2, 1, and how do I transfer that onto a graph, Jenna?
Negative 2 to the left, and then 1 to the up.
1 to the up?
Mm-hmm.
And
put
then
a dot.
When I'm there, I put a dot.
That.
How many of these dots could I possibly make?
Infinite.
Theoretically,
five.
An infinite number.
As many as you want.
As many as you want. How many do we want to make?
Five.
Well,
two.
If we could make fewer, would we like to make fewer?
Six.
Yeah.
Two. But for now, let's make six.
What?
While we pretend like, while we pretend like we don't know what this graph should look like. So, negative 1, 3. Try to make it pretty good looking. 0, 5. 1, 7. 2, and I may not have any room after this one. 9. So far, I've only been able to do 5. I can't fit the 6th one because that one's way up there at 31. Could there be points in between these points?
Yeah.
Yeah? And these?
Yeah.
Between these ones?
All of them.
And these ones? And if we were to draw all of those points, and we just plotted it, all infinity of them, all those points would start to kind of get so close together there wouldn't be any gaps in between anymore, and what kind of shape would it start to make?
Bye-bye.
A straight line, right? There's some points in between here, and there's some points in between here, and here, and here. And you realize that this kind of function has a specific kind of a pattern. Every time I move over 1, I move up 2, and I'm at the next point, or at a point. Right? There's not really a next point, is there? Why do I say that, Trevor? Why is there not the next point?
I don't know. Because it might not be.
Because in this question, there isn't.
After this point, along this line, which point is the next point?
-1.
Is this a point on the line?
Yes.
Is it the next point? If it were the next point, then couldn't I put a point right there? Between those two points? Is that the next point?
Define next.
All right, define next. Next would be the one right next to this point. Is there a point right next to this one?
Yes.
For any two points on a graph, could I put a point in between those ones? Can I put a point between those ones?
Yeah.
And between those?
Yeah.
Are there two points right next to each other?
Yeah.
With no gap in between? No.
I mean, if you report to, sure.
Okay. So, the point there is that there's an infinite number of points. Between any two points, I could put another point. And in between those two points, I could put a point in between those two points. Okay. And we would never fill in all the gaps. As a human being. Theoretically, though, since there are an infinite number of points, all those gaps get filled in by all those points. And the point is that this is not the next point, this is not the next point. But if we go to the right 1 and up 2, we'll get to another point. If we go over 1 and up 2 again, we'll get to another point. And over 1 and up 2 again, we'll get to another point. And then we'll keep on going for how long? Forever. Until you die. Okay? Forever and ever, going over 1 and up 2 will get me to another point on this graph, which works because it's a line.
There's a short guide for that graph.
And you can see that 2 over 1 every time I plug in an x that's one more, one bigger, I add 2 more on to my y value. Go up by 2. Over 1 on the x, up 2 on the y. Or up 2 on the y, over 1 on the x. Alright, let's look at another function. Another linear function. I'm going to give you just a couple of guidelines. I want you to give it 2 negative inputs and at least 2 positive inputs. Okay. You decide what those inputs are going to be, but I want 2 of them to be negative and 2 of them to be positive. You can go more if you want. I'm going to start by plugging 3 in to push you in the right direction, because a lot of you have done little to nothing. 2/3 times 3
yep.
minus 4.
Minus 3.
1. You don't remember how to multiply fractions, multiply straight across. 2 times 3 is 6. 3 times 1 is 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. Now, the thing that I want you to think about, you saw all of that happen. This is an important piece. We got a 2 here. Where did the 2 come from?
Oh, 2 came from
dividing 3 into 6. 6 divided by 3 is 2. Okay? So it's nice if this is a 6, because 6 is divisible by 3. Where did this 6 come from?
2 times 3.
2 times 3. Where'd the 3 come from?
From x.
From x, and who told you to put 3 there?
You.
I did. I told you to put 3 there when you did. The nice thing happened that we multiplied 2 times 3 and got 6, and 6 is a nice number because 6 is divisible by 3, and so it comes out to be a nice whole number, okay? So when you continue to work on this problem, as I asked you to do several minutes ago, and you choose your inputs, it would be nice if this kind of thing happened again. Give that some thought. Someone suggests another input that we could use where this nice thing happens here, where we wind up getting a whole number.
9.
Ooh,
that's
9?
Yeah.
No.
9.
Nine.
Let's try 9. Requires very little talking from anyone but Wyatt. It's Wyatt's idea. So we plug a 9 in there. What do we get here in this next step, Wyatt?
Huh?
When you multiply 2/3 by 9 over 1, we get what here? 18 over 3. Is 18 divisible by 3?
Yes.
I feel like it's not though.
It's 6. 6 minus 4, that's be positive 2. Is there a number between 3 and 9 that would have worked as well?
Mm-hmm.
Number between 3 and 6 would have worked out nicely. 6.
Yeah, I heard that.
We plug in 6. What do we get here? 12 over 3. What's 12 divided by 3?
4.
What's 4 minus 4?
0.
0. We plug in 6, we get 0.
We plug in -3. And I also plug in 0.
0? 0 is always a nice thing to plug in for x, because what happens when you multiply by 0?
0.
So we don't even need to write this down. 2/3 times 0 is 0 minus 4 is negative 4. What's a negative number that would work out nicely?
3.
Negative
3. What's 2 times negative 3?
Negative
6. 6 divided by 3 is? Minus 4. So negative 3. Six. It's another negative 6. What kind of numbers are we discovering are good numbers to pick?
Multiple 3.
multiples of three. Why do we want to pick multiples of three?
Because of the three on the bottom.
Because of the three on the bottom, that's crucial there. Because we know we're gonna divide by three, so we'd like the x to move in steps of threes. We're discovering more about the slope right now. Negative six is a good one. Two times negative six, 12, negative 12 divided by three.
Four,
negative four minus four, negative eight.
That's exactly what I did.
So the x's are moving up by how much?
Three.
By three. Still?
Yeah.
Three. Again?
Three.
And again? And again, the x's are moving up three. Why are they moving up three?
Well,
we picked it, right?
Yeah.
So why are we picking to move by three? Because the denominator is 3, and when we work it out here, we would like it to be divisible by 3, so we make sure to choose things that have a 3 factor in them.
Yeah.
So if we pick numbers that have a factor of 3, we make sure, we guarantee that in this step we get a number that's divisible by 3. So we're moving up in steps of 3 at the x, and what's the y doing?
It's going up 2.
By 2.
By 2.
Dude, look at that. The x moves up by 3, and the y moves up by 2.
Yeah.
Does the x have to move up by 3?
Yes.
Does it have to?
No, it can be variables.
But could I do negative 2? Is it possible or impossible to put negative 2 in?
Yeah, it is, but then you have a weird line.
You have a weird line?
With your 3, isn't it?
Let's see. Let's try negative 2. Why, you plugged in negative 2, didn't you?
What?
Can you put negative 2 in there?
Yeah.
What'd you get?
Negative
5.3. Negative
5.3.
Yes.
Repeating. Now, it's a weird number, but does it mess up our line? Let's find out.
No.
Negative 6, negative 8. That's that point right there, negative 6, negative 8.
Yeah.
Let's jump to negative 3, negative 6. Negative 3, negative 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No, negative
5, 0. 0,
negative 4.
Okay, 0, negative 4.
Right there.
There.
Yeah.
3, negative 2. 6, 0.
Yeah, 6, 0.
9, 2. But let's look at that point at negative 2. Negative 2, negative 5.3. Negative 2, negative, there's negative 4, negative 5.3. Does that make our line weird?
No.
It's different with the points, but it's fine. It's still there. Part of the function is just the weight.
But it's not out of line, right? It's right in line with the rest of the points. Right? So, and if we were to plug in negative 1, I bet you'll get something right in about there, maybe negative 4 and 1/3. And all the points, if I were perfect at drawing graphs.
That is not a straight line.
It should be.
Well, it's not a straight graph either, so
you're
right.
Right, the graph is all off. So, we notice that the pattern is x moves over by 3 and y moves up by 2.
Yeah.
X moves over by 3, y moves up by 2. 3, 2, 3, 2, the slope. Yes, the slope. The y value changes this much. Y value changes this much, and the x value changes this much.
Yeah.
That is just an easy way to find some points. Okay. So, any function that looks like this, and we have talked about three functions so far that look just like this, y equals a number times x plus b.
Ax plus
x we would like to move through the x's by this much each time, right? Carson said it for us earlier, or is it Trevor? I don't know, because that's what the denominator is.
Both
of you, the denominator is 3. If the denominator were 5, we'd want to move along the x in steps of 5. If the denominator were -2, well, I'd still want to move along in 2s because I just want it to be divisible by 2. So since we know that...
Don't disappoint your class.
Any function that looks like this is going to have that stepwise pattern to its graph, otherwise known as the slope of the line. It will all be lines. That's why we call this a linear function. Because when you look at its graph, it's a line. So let's see if we can use this pattern to our advantage in graphing these things without very much work. Because we know the pattern is going to be, let's move along in the x by this much, and move along in the y direction by this much. Okay? I want to see if each individual person can do it.
Can do what?
Y equals 4/5 x minus 2. Here's a push in the right direction. We know how to get from one point to another point on the line, right? This one, for example, we can move to the right 3 and up 2.
So what are we doing?
But first, the first thing we need is a point to start with. You have to know where to start. You can't just pick a point randomly anywhere in the plane. You've got to find a point that's on this line. You just want to make that as easy as possible. It'll take about 2 minutes. Each individual person and see if you can find the easiest point on this line. The easiest point to find on this line. Shh, don't give it away. Everybody think of for a couple minutes. Take a look. Where did the points come from? Like, where did we find these points? These points, where did we find them, Jenna?
By going along with the denominator.
Yeah, we plugged something in for x and the thing we chose was, well, a multiple of 3 in this case. So we plugged something in for x to find the y, and once you know the x and the y, there's the coordinates of a point. So, what would be the easiest thing we can plug in for x? Jenna?
-10, -5, 0, 5, 10.
So all of those options, which would be the easiest?
5.
Is there one even easier than 5?
Yeah. 0.
You already said it. You gave me a list, -10, -5, 0, 5, 10?
0.
0. I didn't hear you say 0. 0 would be the easiest, right? Because 0 times anything
is
0. So, I don't even need to really look at this very long or very hard. I just say, what do I get when I plug 0 in?
-2.
-2, that's 0. All that's left is -2, subtract 2. So we have a point at 0, -2. Right, because if my function's a linear function, and for now they are all linear functions that we're going to look at, if I plug 0 in for x, all that's ever left is
0.
Well, 0 for that, and b, when I add b on, b is what I get. Right? So we'll always have a point at 0, b, which is what we call, what's the name of this point? This point has a special name because of the y-intercept.
I thought you were, okay, never mind. I was thinking more like.
Okay, that was great.
Well, the position is on the y-axis.
Yeah, but
so.
I was thinking more like exactly point on to the.
Well, it has a coordinate, 0, -2, but there's a name, a special name, y-intercept.
Ew.
Ariel. Okay, so we found the easiest point to find, and then we know like how we would want to move and find the next point, right? There's like, Jenna, what did you say were easier numbers to plug in for x?
The ones that
match up with the denominator. Match up with the denominator, -5, +5, -10, +10.
-20 on, -25.
-20, -25. So if I go to an x of 5, right? Well, that would be -2 plus 5 would cancel the 5, we'd just be adding 4. We move to the right 5, x is 5, and we'll take negative 2 and add 4.
Okay.
Over 5, up 4, which is 2. Divide 2. Okay, where could I find another point? Carson, how would I find another point? Easy to find point. Well, it's the same question, or if you answer this question, it'll be pretty much the same answer as what I just asked. What other number would you like to plug in for x, if you choose any number for x? What would you plug in for x so that it would make this multiplication easy? You were saying it, you came up with it last time for this problem. Right? We chose x's that... So what kind of an x would you like to choose in this case? 10, 15, 20, 25, right?
2 billion.
Well, we already went to 5, so we'll go to 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. And if I plug in 10, 10 divided by 5 is 2. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 minus 2 is 6, right? Which is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just 4 above this previous one. Over 5 and up 4. There's another point. Over 5 and up 4. Right? What if we go this way?
10. 10.
Go back 5?
Yeah.
Negative 10.
And? Go down 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 to negative 6. There's another point. Connect those. Okay. Next time, I want you to have these graphs graphed.